Everyone, welcome to the lecture. In this lecture we are going to discuss about line of balance, just in time, that is JIT, and Kanban system. First, coming to the line of balance, the line of balance is a management control process for collecting, measuring and presenting facts related to time, cost and accomplishment, all measured against a specific plan. For example, in manufacturing, we have some terms or we have some steps. Those are all, we are collecting the information and we are measuring that need, as well as we are measuring that importance of that item, and we are presenting the facts of that item based on the time and based on the cost and based on the accomplishment. These are all things we controlled by using single technique or single process, not a technique, that is called as line of balance. It shows the process of the status, background, timing and phasing of the project activities. It provides managing with measuring tools that helps. First one is comparing actual progress with a formal objective plan. It means every production or every product manufacturing, we have an objective, and also we are following some certain procedures for that process. Here in this LOB, we are comparing the actual progress with a formal objective plan. It was properly executed or not, or the process was done by a proper manner or not. We are going to comparing with the actual progress. Next, examining only the deviation from established plans and gauging their degree of severity with respect to the remainder of the project. Here we are examine the deviations from the established plans. What are the steps involved and what is the engineering information, what are the techniques we followed, those things we are examined, and we are giving some reminder for that project, and receiving timely information concerning trouble areas and indicating areas where appropriate corrective actions is required. These are the things we followed in line of balance, and it is the line of balance itself, it is a graphic device that enables a manager to see a single glance which activities of the operations are in balance, that is whether those which should have been completed at the time of the review actually are completed, and whether any activity should be for future completion or lagging behind the schedule. Those things we identified. Here we are reviewing the process and we are reviewing the production according to that process plan. If any deviations are there, we are going to identify and we are going to complete that deviations, and we are going to close the deviations as per that schedule. Next, coming to the LOP levels, here the LOB chart comprises only one feature of the whole philosophy, which includes numerous danger signals control for all various levels of management concerned. Here, to do a line of balance, the following is needed. First, we need a contract schedule or a objective chart. For the LOP, we required a plan or a objective is required. That is called as a contract schedule. Before we are going to do a production, we think about that product, and when we fix some goals or some objectives, those are required for this line of balance. Then second one is a production plan or lead time lead time chart for the production process itself is required. Production plan is required for the line of balance, and control points, cumulative inventories are required. And a program status chart on which to plot a line of balance and the cumulative qualities of units that have passed through the control points of the assembly or production process is required for the line of balance. Coming to the example of line of balance, here we have seen these three levels in this diagram. First one is objective. It is also called as contract schedule. Here our objective is we are doing some survey, that is actual delivery we have, and month wise the months we are considering. Here we are taken 7 months. For these 7 months we have the contract schedule, that is the cumulative schedule we have, and also we have the actual delivery. According to the delivery we are going to deliver the items. These are the units, number of units we delivered. Here our goal is we are going to deliver the items to the required or to the needy, and also we are going to improve the contract schedule. This is our graph, actual delivery this is, but our plan is like this. We are going to deliver the items to the topmost position. Next, coming to the program status, everywhere we are going to check about the program status. The schedule was properly implemented or not, the schedule was properly executed or not. We are going to examine the process plan and we are going to examine the schedule. Here, coming to this program status, here we are taking the bar. Here, this bar, as per the program status, we are going to check line of balance, how the process was done, and how we are delivering the items, and what is the actual delivery. Those things we are calculated. This is the line of balance and production plan. Here it is a purchased part. First we purchased the items, and after purchasing we are going to the company mode. This is the round is called as the purchase part, and the legend square is purchased company mode. And here again we have one more square, that is called as scheduled part. And triangle represents the assembly. These are the things we are planning. First we are procuring the material, that is the purchase part. Then we are going to the company mode. In that company mode we subcontract the part, and we are giving developing the parts, and then we are going to assemble that parts. Here this process we are giving, we are using some external agencies. Sometimes we are directly we did this process. This is the example of line of balance. Next, coming to the advantages of line of balance, it is a simple and very useful technique for planning and controlling the production operations. And here it is like a similar to network analysis, like PET and CPM. Here sometimes we are going to find the route or find the path, the shortest routes we are calculating by the help of line of balance. And also sometimes we are going to calculate the earliest times and latest times for delivering the items, and we are calculating the sales with help of the earliest time and latest time. And we are going to calculate the production planning made, we are going to plan the production plan through the LOP technique. And through LOP technique is simple, it is follows an effective procedure which meets man assumptions. What we are thinking, those assumptions we are going to simply execute or simply satisfy by the help of LOB. And the next one is LOB is a customer oriented, but it is not a manufacturing orientation. As for the thoughts or as for the assumptions of the customer, we developed or we prepared this line of balance. Next, coming to the applications of line of balance, here the insight of the development of material resource planning, that is manufacturing resource planning. The majority of the small companies and non-manufacturing organizations are considered line of balance technique as useful technique and applying in their organizations. Here this technique is also made computerized, and here many computers programs are developed to implement line of balance technique. Computerized line of balance technique is applicable to situation where huge number of operations are required to be undertaken and a progressive reviews are to be done at frequent intervals. Here sometimes we are doing some processes, for that processes we did some many operations. For that controlling of that operations we are using some computers. That computer programs are useful to monitoring and controlling that operations. That is also we considered as a line of balance, and computer programs make the application of line of balance technique easy. Next, coming to the just-in-time, the just-in-time is also known as JIT inventory. It is an inventory management method where by the labor, man, material and good are refilled or scheduled to arrive exactly when needed in the manufacturing process. Here, for example, we are doing some process. In the middle of that process, we require some amount of materials, or we require some amount of labor, or we require some amount of goods to be used in the manufacturing. Those are all things we refilled or we scheduled to arrive exactly to that at the time of production or at the time of shortage. That is called as the just-in-time. The JIT approach has the capacity, when adequately applied to the organization, to improve the competitiveness of the organization in the market significantly by minimizing wastes and improving production efficiency and product quality. When we are implementing proper processes or proper schedules, there we are going to avoid the wastage, or there we are going to minimize the wastage. At the same time, we are going to improve the product efficiency, and also we are going to improve the product quality. How we are improving the product efficiency means, here at the time of requirement, we are giving the supply of the material, manpower and goods. So simply we are going to avoid the wastage, and also we are improving the quality of that product. Next, coming to the objectives of just-in-time. Here we produce only those goods and services which are required by the customers which desired futures, and it produces good and better quality products for the customers on time. To make use of those methods which helping strengthening occupational development of workers, and also JIT produces products in minimal lead times, and also produce products without any wastage of labor, materials and equipments. Next, significance of JIT. The main focus of JIT is to identify and correct the obstacles in the production process. And also the objective of just-in-time is increasing the inventory turnover and reduce the holding and all connected costs. And also it shows some hidden problems of inventory. It prevents the just-in-time prevents a company from using exclusive inventory and so smoothness production operations if a specific tasks takes longer than expected or defective part is discovered in the system. This is also one of the main reason why the companies invest in preventive maintenance. When a part, equipment breakdowns, the entire production process we are going to stop. Why we are the mainly the just-in-time process is opted for that manufacturing means to prevent the maintenance. Sometimes some breakdowns will happen, or sometimes some material shortage will happen. Simply with help of JIT, we are going to control that losses or that wastages or that breakdowns. Then we are going to simply stop that production process. Next, significance, this concept was made applicable again by the Japanese firms. It was placing an order up for the materials the same day of the production of the product. Here the JIT approach eliminates the requirement to voluminous inventories and incur heavy carrying other related costs to manufacture. Here, in order to avail the benefits of JIT system, there should be an optimum synchronization between the manufacturing cycle and delivery of the materials. Here, with help of this JIT, we are going to connect that manufacturing cycle and delivery of material by procuring the raw material to by the delivering the material. We have, by delivering the item, we have some cyclic process that connectivity we can implement, or we can did with help of just-in-time. Here it requires good understanding of the suppliers and manufacturers, and the manufacturer in terms of the quantity and delivery of the material. Here the JIT is in the JIT is giving some
misunderstandings between the manufacturer and the suppliers of the material, the entire production process may come to halt. So we are going to avoid with help of this JIT. And next, some of examples we have considered here in JIT system. If we considered a car manufacturer, a car manufacturer of cars operates with bare minimum inventory levels. Here, the strong reliance on the supply chain to deliver the parts required to the manufactured cars. No one will develop cars by their own parts. They simply the manufacturer gives some idea to the manufacturers, and they collect the parts from the various departments or various organizations or various parent institutes. Then they are going to assemble and they release their cars. Here the parts is required in the manufacturing of cars and do not arrive before or after they are needed. Rather they arrive only when they are needed. The JIT is helpful to that supply chain management. Here the JIT implementation wholly depends on the how the manufacturer manages its supplies, and a lot of pressure is exerted on them as the supplier of the materials have to be ready with ample quality material as the needed arises. Next, coming to the elements involved in JIT, here the majorly two elements are involved in this JIT process, that is continuous improvement and eliminating waste. First, coming to the continuous improvement, here attacking fundamental problems and anything that does not add value to the product. It means here attacking fundamental problems and anything that done that does not added value to the product means we are going to resolve some breakages or some failures of that item or some shortages of materials. We are going to avoid by considering the JIT process. So here there is no value to the product. Devising systems to identify production and allied problems. Here it is a simplicity process. Simplicity means it's simple, supplies are simple and easy to understand, easily manageable, and the chances of going wrong are very low. A product oriented layout for less time spent on material and parts movement, and quality control at source to ensure every worker is solely responsible for the quality of their own produced output. Next, here the JIT is we are going to use to eliminating the waste. By implementing the JIT, we are going to eliminate the 7 types of waste. Those are waste from product defects. Sometimes while we are producing or while we are preparing the item, we are going to observe some wastages. Those wastages are, the first one is defects. If we didn't apply or if we didn't follow the certain processes, we may get some defects. So with help of JIT, we are going to reduce that product defects, and also sometimes we are going to waste the time because sometimes we didn't follow the schedules and we don't have the proper planning. Then we are going to waste the process time, or then we are going to waste some delivery time. So those are all we are going to avoid with help of JIT. And transportation waste also we are going to avoid with help of JIT, and inventory waste also we are going to avoid. Next, waste from overproduction. Next, processing waste we are avoiding with help of JIT. Next, coming to the principles of JIT, here the production should not be carried out until and unless the customer places an order, and make sure that the demands of the customers are met as per the criteria specified by the customers. Here the production should not be carried out until unless the customer places an order. Means for example, if suppose we have any order or we have any requirement from the manufacturer or customer, then only we start the production, otherwise we can't start the production. So this is also one principle of JIT. Based on the just in time we did the production, if suppose the order will receive at the time, means the now we receive order means we are going to start the production at itself, at the present minute itself. Just make sure that the demands of the customers are met as per the criteria specified by the customers. So here we are going to satisfy the customer demands and we are going to approach or we are going to reach the customer's demand so that the JIT is useful to reach their goals or reach their objectives. Let's relate all processes to customer demand using simple visible technique. Here the customer demand using simple visible technique known as Kanban system we are using to relate all processes to the customer's demand, and there should be enough adaptability of workforce and machinery, and try to minimize waste as far as possible. Next, work towards continuous improvement of production product flow. Here we ensure production of good quality product, try to avoid unfortunate incidents, follow procedure, produce to order production schedules and unitary production system. Next, maintain demand level to ensure smooth processing across the plant. Next, coming to the advantages of JIT. Here JIT approach keeps stock holding cost to minimum level. So simply we are going to avoid the unnecessary stockage or unnecessary storage of the stock. As per the requirement we are going to procuring, and as per the requirement we are going to start the production, and the released capacity results in better utilization of space and BS has bear as a favorable impact on the insurance premiums and rent that would otherwise be needed to be made. Here the just-in-time approach helps to eliminate waste. Already we discussed about the waste like defects, time, those are all things. Here chances of expired or out of date products do not arise at all. Here we are following the just-in-time means when we required that time then only we are going to procure or then only we are going to start the production. That's the reason we are going to simply avoid these chances of expired or out of date products. For example, if we prepare a product before the order means some days after the lifetime will be stopped or the lifetime will be over, the delivery, the expiry date will be arrived, so that the reason the product may be wasted. So those things we are going to avoid with help of JIT. Next, as under this management method, only essential stocks which are required for it to manufacturing are obtained, thus less working capital is required. Next, the JIT is a minimum reordering level is set, and only when that level is reached, order for fresh stocks are made, and thus this becomes a boon to inventory management. And this approach works on a demand full basis. All goods produced would be sold, and thus it includes changes in demand with unanticipated ease. This makes JIT appealing today where the market demand is fickle and somewhat violent, and it is due to the above mentioned low level of stock held, the return on investment of the organization be high in general. Next, coming to the another advantages, the JIT emphasizes the right first time concept so that rework cost and the cost of inspection is minimized. Here we are doing the production or we are doing the process when we required that item then only, so that the reason we are going to avoid the wastages. With help of these reducing wastage means we are going to reduce the rework, so that reason we are going to reduce the rework costs and cost of inspection also. So by following it, greater efficiency and high quality products can be derived, and also it relationships are fostered along the production chain under the JIT system. Next, higher customer satisfaction due to continuous communication with the customer. The just-in-time adoption result in the elimination of overproduction. Next, coming to the disadvantages, here we have some disadvantages in the JIT process. JIT approach states zero tolerance for mistakes, making rework difficult in practice. As inventory is kept to a minimum level, a successful application of JIT requires a high reliance on suppliers whose performance is outside the purview of the manufacturer. And also, due to no buffers in JIT, production line idling and downtime can occur, which would have an unfavorable effect on the production process and also on the finances. Next, here we are reducing the chances are quite high of not meeting an unexpected increase in orders, as there will be no excess inventory of finished goods. Its transaction costs would be comparatively high depending upon the frequency of transactions. As JIT may have certain negative effects on the environment due to the frequent deliveries, as the same would result in higher use and cost of transportation, which in turn would consume more fossil fuels. As coming to the another one is Kanban system. Here the Kanban system is one of the most important tool in JIT system. It is regarded as the heart of JIT system. And Kanban system is a scheduling system which quickly and vividly communicates the demand of the customers to the delivery system. Here we are simply scheduling the demand according to the demand we are going to produce the item. So that the reason we are calling this Kanban system is heart of the just in time. The just in time also we started the production at the time of requirement. Here we didn't prepare or we didn't start the production before the order. So it collects the information of what and when customer demand so that they can produce and deliver them accordingly. Okay. Next, coming to the process of implementing Kanban. Here we have different steps to implementing the Kanban system. The first one is collection of data. Here we are collecting the information about the production process, and we are collecting the data facilities in the decision making process based on the facts and not on wants. Here the data collection should not hold any collector or prejudge basis. Next one is collecting the Kanban size. Here the size Kanban container is computed in the basis of present situation and not on the basis of the future plans or wastes. Here purely we consider the current situation. What is the demand in market and how much quantity is required? According to that we prepared the we start the production. According to that we are planning our process. So we are that demand or that requirement is called as the Kanban size or Kanban container. Okay, these computations would make use of production requirement system, scrap rate, process productivity rate, plan down and change over times in order to compute the replenishment intervals. Here the quantities to be ordered are then decided on the basis of replenishment interval. Here the amount of safety stock required for process cure, drying or normalization period are also included in the final Kanban container questionnaire. Here we don't know about the demand, so that according to that forecast of the demand we are going to maintain the stock. If suppose suddenly we may get some orders, means simply we are going to start the production by taking the stock of that material, stock of the raw material to the workstations. Okay, then the third one is designing the Kanban. Here we have some steps to designing the Kanban system, and also we have some questions to designing the Kanban system. First one is how the material would be monitored, and the second one is what will be the visual signals, and third one is what roles must be followed for implementing the Kanban. Next, who is responsible for taking care of the Kanban transaction? Who is supposed to take the scheduling decisions? Who must be solve the problems? What is the requirement of the visual management items? What type of training must be provided? And how the implementation schedule must be? These are the questions we considered while designing the Kanban. Next, an implementation of plan along with the implementation actions, assignments and scheduled milestones must be the final outcome of this step. Then the fourth one is training everyone. Here in this stage we are training, we are providing the training to everyone which is related to the working system and role of each individual person in the process imparted. And here the main objective of this training to emphasize is upon understanding the functioning of the Kanban, and also it provides through the simple presentation which explains about the process and the visual signals. Next one is starting the Kanban. When we are going to start? Here it means all the visible management wishes should be placed accurately before implementing the Kanban process. Here the settings, the setting up of signals, marking of control points, completion and coordination of roles prior to the beginning of Kanban process would make the training easier and would also neglect chores. Here the Kanban system is started, the problems that may derive or that may drive should be identified and appropriate action must be taken for resolving them. Here it finally scheduled transition plan should be developed during the development stage in order to ascertain the correct point of change and the stock of inventory needed for making a change. Next one is auditing and maintaining the Kanban. Here the final step is to go for auditing and the Kanban. Here the auditor makes sure that the scheduling signals are handled effectively and the customers are being supplied as desired. And also in case if the auditor identifies any problem, it must be corrected immediately, as the immediate response would result in success of the Kanban. Next one is the Kanban quantities are adjusted as per the forecasted demand in order to avoid regular manual intervention in the scheduling process, which is likely to stop the Kanban implementation. Next one is improving Kanban. Here the ultimate last step of Kanban is its improvement. The major emphasis must be laid down on finding out new methods and techniques to improve the Kanban process. Unless until the process is perfect and flawless in itself, it would not be beneficial to the firm. Thus, utmost care and efforts must be made in order to enhance the functioning of a Kanban system. These are the processes of implementing the Kanban system. Next, coming to the elements of just-in-time. Here we are using some elements in just-in-time process. Those are all. First one is waste elimination. Already we discussed waste refers to any action which influences quality of the product. And also we discussed about enforced problem solving. Earlier we discussed that is JIT system makes use of enforced problem solving for improving the production process and methods continuously with the help of JIT system. Here we are low inventories are maintained and the problems related to quality, machine breakdowns, workload imbalances, material stockouts, worker absenteeism and out of specification materials are solved to a great extension. Next, continuous improvement. This is also one of the element already we discussed. Here which helps the firm to become successful. The managers must be provided training to the employees and should motivate them so that they can identify the production problems taking place and reduce them. Next one is employee involvement and empowerment. Here the employees involvement plays a very important role in the successful implementation of JIT system. All the employees involved in the JIT system would be dedicated and committed towards solving the production problems. Employee empowerment and also plays an important role in the JIT system. Next, coming to the quality, total quality management. This is also an element we are used. And parallel processing, these are the elements of JIT. Similarly, we have the elements in Kanban system. These are first Kanban logic, second one is Kanban as part of JIT production, third one is advantages of Kanban system. First, coming to the first one, that is Kanban logic. Here there are two types of Kanban cards in traditional Kanban system. First one is the withdrawal Kanban, also allows the production batch to move, and the supplier receives this card when the material is utilized from the cycle inventory, and the flow of material from the supplier to the manufacturing place is controlled by this card. Next one is the production Kanban. This is called allows the production to take place when the material is withdrawn from the buffer inventory of supplier. Once the materials are transferred, the production Kanban card is released and it is issued in upstream manufacturing phase, and the number of production batches in operations are controlled by the number of Kanban cards. The various factors that are considered while calculating the batch size, including cycle time, manufacturing setup, production needs, etc. Next, coming to the Kanban as a part of JIT production. Here, the Kanban system can operate effectively only when the principle of JIT manufacturing are implemented. According to the system, such as production smoothing, investment activities, job standardization, design of machine layout, automation, reduction of setup time, etc. Here, support the Kanban system in the Toyota production system. Okay. Next, coming to the advantages of Kanban system, it is easy to understand, and it is highly reliable and visible. It connects the operations tightly. It is reasonable to improvement. This is about Kanban system. So far, we discussed about line of balance, just in time, Kanban system. Okay, thank you.